Tonight on Psalms Over Schools Today, we will take a look at how one famous singer won a huge award for writing.
And as always, we have a look at some of the events from around the school district. Psalms Over Schools Today starts in 2 minutes. Do you think this is-
Hi, do you have ID?
Yep.
Oh, okay, thanks.
No, I don't.
Oh, well, you can't be in the building without ID.
It's okay.
Yes, security, please. There's a young man in the building without ID, and he's running away from my post here at Ball Duty.
Hello, and welcome to Psalms Over Schools Today for Tuesday, October the 18th. I'm Danielle Esco.
And I'm Emily Lord. Later on tonight, we will see how one man gave something that will not soon be forgotten.
But up first tonight, we'll take a look at our elementary schools and our elementary happenings.
Starting off our elementary happenings, please bring your food for donation to Westover for Food Drive Friday. Your help can go a long way.
Let's take a look at today's random fact of the day.
Hi, I'm Matt Abbott with TV21's random fact of the day. Did you know that the Cat in the Hat's first name is Abraham?
If not for her Missouri dog, a Missouri woman might be dead, Linda Russell reports.
As the flames shot from the roof and smoke poured out of this home on Highway J, the 911 call late Thursday morning came from Diane Gaddy herself. As fire crews arrived, she was already outside.
She had made it out to her car. She'd got her dog out, and she was able to make it out. Outside without any injuries.
If it weren't for Queenie, Diane's service dog of 8 years, her husband, who wasn't home at the time, knows things may have turned out differently.
Yeah, the dog woke her up.
I spoke with Diane off camera. She tells me she believes she fell asleep in her computer chair, and then her service dog, Queenie, woke her up, alerting her to the smoke in the house, so she was able to get out safe.
Could have been a much worse outcome.
That's really the only thing that matters. The rest of it's material stuff. It's a house, and it's some stuff in a house, but that's okay because she's still here. So that's all I really care about.
For the Gaddies, the lifesaver came in the form of a dedicated four-legged friend. But Chief Sturtz hopes everyone has a warning.
Well, not many people are going to have service dogs wake them up. Get those fire detectors checked, batteries, and if you need some help with that, please call your local fire district. I'm sure any of us will be willing to come out and check it.
JW is just thankful Queenie was by Diane's side when she needed her most.
That's why I think everybody needs a dog. I love my dog, and she's, that's what they're there for. They take care of us.
It's time to take a trip around the world in our 60-second road trip. Can you guess where we are today?
Moving to Northover, the students at the Home of the Pirates had a chance to look back in the last week. The district removed a memory box that was buried 60 years ago. Here's a look.
I'm Julie Harold with Toms River Schools Today. We had a chance to go back in time with Northover Elementary and look at their 60-year-old time capsule. Let's take a look.
You guys can swing right around here. Swing around.
There was a rumor that was going around that there might be a time capsule buried somewhere around North Dover at the time it was built in 1956. I spoke with Mark Wagner, head of maintenance. He took out the blueprints and the plans, and he said there might be something there because there is room. So today, we invited two students from each class, our Masons, as well as central administration and one of our board members to come and see if there was actually something behind that cornerstone of 1956.
I was like, wait, there's a time capsule in there? I was very surprised I didn't think it would really be able to survive there for that long, 60 years.
Well, it's an exciting time because we're discovering history of 60 years ago. And, it's a very intriguing event for all of us, not only young kids, but adults, to see what was going on back in our school district 60 years ago.
What a great way to learn about Toms River Schools history here at North Dover. With Toms River Schools Today, I'm Julia Harrell.
A good Samaritan, a good deed, and two people who could really use some help all collide in one Missouri town as Krista Double reports, the end of this story is way better than a fairy tale.
Two locations. One of them was the corner restaurant in Westport. We watched Courtney, our unsuspecting server, do her work. The man came in, sat briefly for a beverage, and then got his chance to chat with Courtney. He found out she's caring for her sick mom. He told Courtney he had something for her. It was a tip in an envelope, even though he wasn't going to eat. She was clearly surprised by the gesture. He left, and we were hoping to capture Courtney opening the envelope, but she just kept working. So her boss, who was in on the surprise tip, had to go get her. And then...
Are you serious? This is incredible. I've never even had... I don't even know what to do.
Immediately you said you were going to do something for your mom with this.
Uh-huh.
Can you take a little bit of it and do something for yourself? What could that be? If you could do something for yourself, what would it be?
I need to get new tags. I'll definitely probably get maybe my nails done or something. I don't know.
Okay,
something nice, but groceries.
Next up was the first watch nearby. This time, the Good Samaritan was seated in Mauricio's section. Mauricio, again, had no idea.
Okay, then also don't forget to check the special that we have right here.
A server for 10 years, Mauricio moves quickly around the restaurant, always with a smile. He caught us taking his picture, so we moved in. And the Good Samaritan, as he had planned, moved out.
Oh my God!
Is this the biggest tip you've ever gotten?
This is the bigger in my whole life.
So what can you do with that money?
What can I do with this money? I want to tell you, I'm saving money to go to see my family in Chile. And this is what I have a lot. Thank you, appreciate it so much.
It's now time for us to take a look at the dictionary.com's word of the day. Today's word is waggish, meaning resembling the characteristic of a wag. And now for today's sentence. As the wind began to pick up, the flag had a waggish way at the top of the flagpole.
Now we're going to take a short break, but coming up, we take a look at our intermediate happenings.
And we also take a look at your weather, so stick around, we'll be right back. Your time never seems so good. I've been inclined
to believe that never would. I used to have a goat. Where did it go? It went to a family who really needed it. You see, giving a family an animal is like giving them a business. The wool, milk, eggs all turn into income for medicine, school, clothing, a better home.
a sustainable livelihood. Soon, the family is passing on the gift of the animal's offspring to another family who does the same, and on until the whole community is lifted out of poverty. That is where my goat went, and that's why you give to Heifer International.
Welcome back. Starting off our intermediate happenings at Intermediate South, it's Seminole Spirit Day every Friday. Don't forget to wear your Seminole colors. Spirit wear is on sale in the school store.
All students are reminded if they would like to see any sporting event at Intermediate South, you must go home first and return at the game with an adult.
It's now time for our environmental tip of the day. Each day we will bring you a tip to help save the environment. Let's take a look at today's tip.
I'm Lex Bischoff with your environmental tip of the day. Green to go, not brewing at home? Take a travel cup to your favorite Java joint. They may fill it at a discount.
Every day on the show, we will be bringing you a tip of the day. So stay tuned tomorrow as we give you another way to help save the environment.
Jumping off a bridge sounds a little crazy, but not to several people. In West Virginia this weekend, some base jumpers plunged off a nearly 900-foot bridge at the New River Gorge Saturday. Just for fun, as Justin McLennan reports, a huge crowd turned out to see them.
For the tens of thousands attending Bridge Day 2016, it's all about seeing this iconic state symbol from a different perspective.
To walk across the bridge that you normally drive across, it's pretty exciting, and then to go below and look back up at the jumpers.
Each October, thrill seekers and spectators from all over come to experience the bridge in their own way.
It has been awesome. The weather's perfect, and watching the jumpers is a great thing.
Some of them are shaking a little bit, some of them are nervous, some of them are excited, and then to see them plunge and to float through the air and then wait until the last minute to pull the cord, it's exciting.
Most are perfectly content with watching from the sidelines.
I would never do that.
That takes a lot of guts.
Lots of them.
But for the ones with the guts, the best view is the one from the edge.
Yeah, it's nerve-wracking, even if you've done it. I mean, some of these guys are really good. Maybe they don't get nervous, but I get pretty nervous.
Base jumper Ricky Hoyt traveled 9 hours from upstate New York just for the chance to leap off the bridge.
Good. What
He's repacking his chute to get ready for his third jump of the day.
So we can go any other time, so today, while it's legal, try to get as many as we can in.
Hoyt says if you can block out the nerves, it's really quite simple.
Just clear your mind, step off, and you're good, hopefully.
Here for you at Bridge Day, Justin McLennan, WVVA News.
A storm ripped through the southern Washington state Saturday, leaving behind a mess in some neighborhoods. Keaton Thomas takes a look at the damage in Vancouver.
You always have the threat.
Walt Gear was home alone Saturday afternoon when the winds really started picking up in Vancouver.
So I hurried down to the basement and was sitting down there watching television.
Then he heard it.
It was kind of a crashing, cracking sound.
He walked up the stairs to find this, the top of a maple tree pierced through his roof and kitchen ceiling. From above, you can see it sticking up like a javelin.
It was this trunk right here.
So I asked, what was the first thing that went through his mind when he saw it?
Call my son.
His son came to cut the log into pieces and take it out of the roof. The remnant logs are scattered around the backyard. But now Gear and his wife are left with this gaping hole in their kitchen, which started leaking when we arrived.
Oh, it wasn't dripping before.
But after calling this place home for 40 years, the Gears know things like this can happen in the Pacific Northwest.
We have several large maple trees, and there's always the possibility that something like this might happen.
It sounded like lightning.
On the other side of Vancouver, this tree split in half.
So it was like a...
shook the whole house and it just sat still. Really? You know, yeah.
A large branch leaning on the house where it will remain overnight.
The weight of that on there, we're gonna leave it to the professionals.
It's now time for another break. Coming up later in the show, we'll take a look at your high school happenings.
Tom's River Schools Today, we'll be right back.
Big dreams and good grades aren't enough to get into college. There are actual steps you need to take. Finding someone who can help is the first and most important. For the next steps, go to knowhowtogo.org.
Starting off our high school happenings, attention students and staff. The school store is now open to serve you. We are open every day. We are stocked with all your Raider apparel needs, including Champion and Under Armour brands. The school store is open every day after school from 1:40 to 2 p.m. We also have Yoo-hoo, Snapple, and water for $1, as well as many other delicious snacks to get you energized for your after-school practices. Stop in soon. It's time to get Raiderized.
Moving on. Who wants a free breakfast? The homeroom who has the best attendance for the month of October will win a free breakfast.
Lead and Seed is now accepting applications. This is a drug prevention club which supports healthy and lifestyle choices. We work to reduce substance abuse in our community and our school. If interested, please pick up an application in the main office.
Calling all Raiders, the class of 2019 is sponsoring a Buddy Bag initiative. Please consider donating items such as socks, toothpaste, mittens, and other small items that could fit into a brown paper bag. These bags will go to helping those in need during the cold winter months. Drop off any items during your lunch period on stage. Thank you so much for helping with this fundraiser. Switching to High School North, every Wednesday is Green Day at North. Remember to wear green to help get the word out about your need for recycling and energy conservation.
At the Home of the Indians, the weight room will be open Monday through Thursday from 1:45 to 3:45.
Let's now take a look at what grinds our gears.
What grinds my gears is when you eat something really hot and then you eat or drink something really cold right after, and then your teeth like have this horrible pain inside. That's what grinds my gears.
It is now time for us to take a short break. After the break, we take a look at your 3-day forecast.
Tom's River Schools Today, we'll be right back.
And she's watching him with those eyes. And she's loving with that body, I just know it. And he's holding her in.
Obsessed, depressed at the same time. I can't even walk it.
little girl till heaven home.
It's easy to tell if you've had way too many. But what if you've had just one too many? Buzz driving is drunk driving.
Starting off sports in East Tennessee, man finds an unusual way to decorate his father's grave. He says it's just what his dad would want. Lauren Halm has the story.
Orange and white, it's a way of life.
God, family, and Tennessee football. It's pretty much the way we've been.
And out here where it's peaceful, you're likely to hear this before a big rivalry game.
The white's a lot easier. It seems like the white covers better.
Nope, it's not the end zone in Neyland Stadium. It's Ricky Beckler's grave, Jamie Beckler's dad, who passed away from pancreatic cancer in 2008.
He wasn't real big on flowers, so we came up with this, and just became a tradition now.
It was a tradition to watch every big orange football game.
He was, you know, quick with the criticism and, you know, also there with the fight that, you know, would pull through it. And
that's why this is so special to this son.
I hope he's watching down and rooting for him, as, you know, especially this season.
Making the checkerboard pattern takes about an hour and a half, and lasts a few months. But is that true Tennessee orange?
Yeah, as close as you can get.
And painting brings Beckler closer to his dad.
Definitely, you know, soul reviving to come up here and, you know, talk to him.
Just looking at it, there's no need to wonder if this Vol for Life is happy with how things look.
He's got that little grin he had on his face right now, I'm sure. Probably humming Rocky Top, too.
Let's now take a look at your three-day forecast. Tomorrow, it stays sunny with a high of 79 and a low of 67. For Thursday, the sun will be out with another high of 79 and a low of 76. Friday. And finally, for Friday, it will be partly cloudy with a high of 76 and a low of 65.
Wrapping up tonight's show, quite a few eyebrows were raised Thursday when the music legend Bob Dylan won the Nobel Peace Prize for Literature. Jeanne Moos reports on why some are throwing the book at the idea.
We'd love to ask Bob Dylan to win the Nobel Prize in Literature, but we couldn't get hold of him.
Literature.
There was shock when the Swedish Academy made the announcement.
Bob Dylan.
A week earlier, the New Republic asked, who will win the 2016 Nobel Prize in Literature? And their answer was, not Bob Dylan. Yet now he'll have another medal to hang with his Medal of Freedom. The news left writer Jason Pinter tweeting, if Bob Dylan can win the Nobel Prize for Literature, then I think Stephen King should get elected to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Round one. The fight boiled down to the question, are lyrics literature? Some critics said no, riffing on Dylan's own song.
For the times they are changing.
The times they are a-endin', wrote one journalist, to which someone replied, delete your account, Dylan, the greatest poet of 20th century, undisputed genius. Some worried naming a songwriter would open the floodgates, so 2034 Nobel for Literature could go to, you never know, posting repetitive Rihanna lyrics. The British paper The Telegraph imagined a Nobel Prize being awarded to Donald Trump for lyrical tweeting. In defense of Dylan, a writer for Rolling Stone tweeted, "They'll stone you when you've won the Nobel Prize." But the Telegraph sniffed, "This is the Nobel Prize for Literature, not Sweden's Got Talent."
Do you think of yourself primarily as a singer or as a poet?
Well, I think of myself more as a song and dance man, you know.
The prize in literature goes to a man better known for words delivered on the stage than on the page.
Is a blowing in the wind.
Jeannie Mo, CNN.
Is blowing in the wind.
New York.
Remember, if you have a story you would like us to cover,
or if you have an announcement about an upcoming event, please send it to InterSchool Mail to the TV21 studio at High School East, or you could email us at tv21@trschools.com.
Also, be sure to tune in to TV21 throughout the day to catch this show, as we bring you stories from around the district. Also, please take a look at our website, www.trschools.com/TV21.
Well, that's a wrap-up for tonight's show. For Toms River Schools Today, I'm Emily Lord.
And I'm Danielle Esco. Have a great night.